Hey, what's going on, YouTube family? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here and this is your first time seeing my face, my name is Mark. Please remember to slash that like button. And also, I know, before you get started, I know there's some people in the back. You got commitment issues. I got commitment issues. But I got a problem that'll solve and remedy all of that. So why don't you just annihilate that subscribe button. And also, to keep up to date with me, hit that post notification bell. And if you still have reservations about it, you can still think of this like a swipe left on Tinder, like we doing a YouTube dating process. But, and also, leave me comments down below. But I think I've talked enough, so let's just jump straight into these videos. Let's go!
Call me Megatron. Shorty's a Megacon. It ain't a
acoustic style. His voice is whoa. Oh, I like how he dropped down.
Will this last or just come and go? It came so fast. Woo.
He killed that. Come on, Alan. He definitely killed that. Okay, so let's quickly talk about Alan Stone with Brown Eye Lover. And can I sit here and say that if I was a judge on The Voice, I would have immediately hit my buzzer and turn around with him singing. With that first opening note, he sent chills down my spine. The way he sat there and just captivated my attention the way that he did with that. And then also what I want to sit there and say is, I believed every word Alan Stone was saying. He could have been like, I had a hazel eye lover. He could have been like, I had a green eye lover. He could have been like, I had a blue eye lover. He could have sat there and told me he had a purple eyed or a red eye lover, like some demon baby or something over there, or across town. I would have been like, okay, like, I would have thought that that was acceptable, because the way he just killed this track, he like annihilated. He could have sat there and said he had a one-eyed lover, and I'd be like, well, where's she at? Like, what's she look like? Because the way that you kill it, like, she must mean something, because you're making a connection to this song. Like, you are just feeling it, and you are giving me raw and pure vocals and just like pure emotion and energy. And I felt like everything that I was buying everything that Alan Stone was selling in this track, because he just gets it when it comes to musicality and performance, and just being able to hit high notes and then drop down the way that he does, and just the control that it takes to be able to do that. I don't sit there and try to act like I'm like some resident vocal coach, but I can tell that that is hard to do, because I know I can't do that. So to me, it's subhuman, at least for me. So I mean, just the way that he does it, to just go up and then drop down and then go back up again, is crazy. The vocal control and like the breath that he's able to control within inside himself to just like let go and just free himself and just get lost in the lyrics is just mind-blowing. I thought he did a phenomenal job with this track. I loved it. I got so lost in translation within the lyrics of the song, and just his whole voice. His whole voice was just like a vibe and a mood that you could just sit there and just vibe out to, because his voice just cuts and pierces through. Like, he just gets it. And it reminds me like when I did, I think it was called, the first track that I reacted to, was it Sunny Days? Somebody correct me in the comments if I'm not correct, but I think it was called Sunny Days. When he did that, and he was like in the middle of the garage. Well, not the garage, but like, what do you call it? Like the junkyard. He was in the middle of the junkyard with all the cars and all that, and just singing right there, and he put all his passion and raw emotion into it. He did the same thing into this, and I loved it. Like, he just gets it. He knows how to sit there and make music his own. You could tell that music is his life, and that he's doing this for the love of it, and he's not doing it for just a check. And I thought he did a phenomenal job with Brown Eye Lover. Like I said, he could have been sitting there saying he had a one eye lover, a half eye lover. He could have sat there and say he had some demon possessed red eye lover, and I would have been like, oh, okay, well, where they at? Like, where they at though? Like, let's go see them. Like, let's go see them. Like, where they at? Like, cause you sitting there like singing about it, and you making me believe it. So he just killed it, and he gets it. So that was phenomenal. I'm not rating that performance, because I think he did an absolutely phenomenal job, especially with that acoustic style. He killed it. And with that being said, let me know what you thought of Alan Stone with Brown Eye Lover in the comments below. And with that being said, please remember to be safe out there. Remember to stay awesome. Be awesome, because you guys are all awesome. This is your boy Mark, and I'm signing off. Deuces. Peace.
They call me Megatron. Shorty's a Megacon. It ain't about the race either. It's the marathon.